Welcome to the Breathing Edge podcast. Today we're going to talk about rise and shine.
Morning routines. Because we did mention about our blueprint for natural flow, and we talked about morning routines and evening routines and other things in between. So we thought, well, let's dig a little deeper on the routine and really what... I mean, our main purpose for this is just to deliver how simple this can be. And also, a lot of things that we're going to talk about are things that you're actually already doing. It's not like we're going to suggest, oh, you know, you're going to have to put another a whole half an hour or a whole hour yoga routine into your day or anything like that. It's not that at all. I mean, yeah. it's going to be some simple add-ons that you can already do if you've already got a morning routine. Or if you're looking to build yourself a morning routine, and one of the ways that we really ask you to set yourself up to win is, well, you listen to the suggestions that we give on here, but really you really need to build your own morning routine because you are more likely to carry it out when you've built it and when you've done it.
I think you learned that from me. I was gonna say we started building our morning routine kind of out of desperation. Shane was waking up in the morning and he's like, he'll wake up and he'll be like, yeah, ready for action. Like, it's probably 13 years in the military, it's instilled in him. And for me, I'm like, you know, used to working in the entertainment
probably
business.
Probably not. I don't think so in the military. Not everyone's like that.
Something in you. And me, when I was working in the entertainment business, you know, I wouldn't wake up sometimes until, maybe if I didn't have to work a morning shift somewhere, I'd wake up around midday. Mm. And so for me coming to Australia, getting used to waking up early and going to sleep early, was a bit of a shift for me in my lifestyle.
Shift in the good direction.
Certainly was.
Stop swimming upstream.
Yes. And that's why we wanted to share just like four simple things that you can do all four, or you can do only one of them, and either one is up to you.
Yeah, we're gonna deliver them to you in order of importance.
Yes. Okay, so the first one, greet the sunrise.
Yeah, number sunrise. One. Now, this may be, people hear this, I think, sometimes and go, one, oh, there's no way I'm getting up for sunrise. That's generally one way we hear. Or number two, it can't be that simple. I'm here to tell you, you've got to get over both of them. You do. You really do.
Now, even look, even mamas.
Yeah, now look, the thing, we're going to give you some really basic stuff about AM sunlight, about the sunrise, about why the sun. Now, you would have heard us discuss on the podcast before about how all the little clocks in your body, especially the little clocks in your cells, are synced with the sun. The sun is the metronome or the master clock that allows your cells or tells your cells when to turn certain things on in the cell and certain things off. And these things can be everything from recycling programs to hormone, the correct type of hormones to be released at certain times. Now, this affects how you digest food, it affects your energy, it affects your mood, it affects your sex drive. It pretty much affects everything that goes on in your body. So if you
chaos
don't...
Chaos in the body, chaos in the
exactly.
mind.
Exactly. So if you don't think it's important, think about this. If you're not actually getting out and seeing any of the sunlight, or you're kind of not in sync when the sun rises, is it any wonder that your body's not in sync? Is it any wonder that your body's producing hormones or not digesting food right, or you're gaining weight, or you've got all these different things? It just means that you're out of sync with the normal cycles. Mm. Now, the process by which this works is quite complex, and we can add some links and some information about it, and you can get into it. But really what happens is the light comes in through your eye and it comes into the water that's produced in the body in the mitochondria. And if you remember back from high school science or science, or you've heard, you're interested in this stuff, mitochondria are all the little powerhouses in the cells. They're the things that run the cell, basically. And believe it or not, these things run off sunlight. They run off sunlight. Your body is full of electricity. I mean, most people know that. And so light is the thing that actually runs the body. I was really, really surprised when I found this. I kind of intuitively had a thought about this.
Yeah, he did. Like, you've always been.
Yeah, but it's quite fascinating. And for anybody out there that really wants to get into it, there's plenty of places that you can go to start looking at this because science is starting to really cotton on. So think about it. That light that comes in from the sun also happens to be perfectly balanced light. So that means that it's got all the spectrums of light in it, and all the different spectrums of light do different things in the body. And I was quite surprised to find out that I'd been told that, you know, cover up in the sun and, you know, this kind of light's bad for you. UV light, you would have heard, a lot of people have heard, UV light's no good for you. Well, it's actually not true. The UV light is actually quite good for you. It just depends on when you get it. And you would have heard timing is everything. Well, it's the same with the circadian rhythm. It's the same with when you get the light into the body. It's the same. All these things run off timing, so that's why timing's important.
Yeah. And the interesting thing that kind of hit it home for me was that if you get sunburned or you don't do well in the sunlight, it's because your body's forgotten how to absorb the sun. So I just kind of went, wow, okay, so we are digging deep into this, because there's a lot of things that I think can be unlocked with just becoming more building more of a relationship with the sun.
And now some of you out there might be thinking, well, what if I live in a place where there's not a lot of sunlight, or you know, like I'm in winter, so I'm not going to see the sun. Well, most of you know, we've all heard that the light still does come through the clouds, so you're still getting the light. You may not be getting it direct from the sun, but there are ways around it. And we would just say, just adjust your morning routine accordingly. You know, just getting outside during that time is just as good if you can't get out and directly witness the sunrise. So just getting up at that time, you know, it's...
Yeah, and that takes us into the second one, that is grounding. Just getting barefoot on the ground, going for a walk barefoot on the beach, or going for a walk barefoot down at the park, or just stepping out on your lawn and looking up and just taking a few breaths and just relaxing and let your body just start to wake up and feel, like, for me, my favorite part is like if feeling the wind and the environment around me, because I'm just inside all day long, so it's kind of nice to get out.
Well, we do live an inside life. Think about it, with the advent of electricity and TVs, and for us as being business owners and entrepreneurs, we are on our laptops quite a bit and our phones. So, you know, so just understanding
that stuff with your rhythm.
If you want, go ahead and research ground. And you'll find a whole lot of interesting things. Really what happens is energy exchange happens. You've got little sweat glands in your feet and in your hands that actually do this little energy exchange process. And a lot of it is involved in the cycling of both light and dark on the earth. And it changes the magnetic fields. There is a change in the magnetic fields at both sunset and sunrise. And so so our bodies working off electricity and magnetism, it's a big deal for the body. So, you know, and you know yourself, when you go out, go to a beach. If you're near a beach or near a forest or anywhere, go out and just put your feet on the ground and you tell us if you don't just feel better. It will naturally lift you. And even better, if you can get your feet into some natural running water, it even highlights it even more. That being on the edge of the beach, or if you're near a stream or a lake or anywhere where it is, even a puddle. if it's raining outside, you know, get your bare feet in the puddle. And this is the thing.
I feel like a kid again.
And you're supposed to. That's what it's about. It's all about conducting. It's all about positive, negative discharges. And that's what happens in the body when we go out and we get into these natural cycles, being sunlight, being grounding on the earth, you're getting this positive, negative discharge.
Yeah. Now, all of a sudden, like, my thoughts are like all the sun worshippers and the cultures that, you know, meet three times a day and do their salutations of sorts. All of a sudden, it doesn't seem like they're that far off from something that could be highly beneficial to all of us.
research, if you research any of the sun worshipping cultures, I guarantee you'll find that they were some of the longest standing cultures on earth. You look at the Egyptians, they were sun worshipping cultures, the Aztecs, all of these ones that we know of in modern times, because they've lasted the test of time, they all had knowledge of the solar and lunar cycles. It's you only have to go, you kind of maybe dig a little bit deeper than what you learned at school, but if you do go and look at it, look at the modern research on these things, and you'll find that it's true, that they all had an alignment with those natural energies.
Now, we've spent a lot of time on sunrise and grounding, and we'll kind of go through and kind of speed through these last two ones, because we're going to actually give you something for free that you can try, a free breathing. So the third one is a breathing, of course.
Yeah.
And there's a lot to be said around that. But one, it's oxygenating, it's cellular respiration, it's getting jump starting your car before you drive away for the day. It's priming your energy and helping to create the flow before you even go work.
So we've mentioned natural cycles being outside of the body. Well, breathing is an internal cycle inside the body. And as Angie mentioned before, starting up the engine, well, breathing and getting oxygen into the body, oxygen is the main transporter of the information and energy in and out of the mitochondria as well. So it's a major part of it. So introducing more oxygen into the body, as well as cycling the breathing, with the breathing that we're going to put on here, you'll notice it's a circular type breathing. There's a lot of circular breathing. This cycling of positive, negative, does it sound familiar? Like we just talked about before, this cycling of positive, negative charges in the body. So what you're doing is you're starting to internally cycle. This will ramp up your energy, and we've just found that it breaks the procrastination from us going, oh, do I really want to go out and get out in the light in the morning? Do I want to go out and ground myself? You get past that because you start to feel your energy rising and you want to do something better for yourself. And this is the process that it follows. So, you know, the breathing, we've talked at length on here about the science of breathing. So if you want to check out some of the earlier podcasts that we did, go back but just know it's really good for you.
Yes, yeah. And that also kind of takes us into breathing is an important mechanism to releasing tension out of the body.
Mm-hmm.
So tension, whether you know it, unconsciously all of us are carrying tension, consciously and unconsciously.
Yeah, so mental, emotional, physical,
spiritual.
Yeah.
So by using the breath to release the tension helps hugely. Now, so does the fourth thing that we're going to talk about, movement. And it doesn't have to be complex. You don't have to go and flog yourself at the gym, although that's going to make you breathe really well. But sometimes just simple movements is enough.
And we're sort of, because we're talking about morning routines, we'll come at this from, hey, you're already out in the sunshine or out in nature in the morning or outside somewhere. You're already breathing. You can have your feet on the ground. You can do your breathing while you do your movement. There's so many different ways that you can combine this in so that it doesn't have to become a big thing. Now, with movement, I've got three principles that I use with movement. I always have one movement that goes back to front, one movement that goes side to side, and one movement that involves some twisting and turning. Now, if you think about that, that covers all three dimensions of movement. So just think about what you learned at school PE or at your local yoga class or if you've been to see a personal trainer or you name it, you know some basic movements for your body that basic stretches. Some of those stretches can be kind of, you'll feel they're back to front. Some of the stretches go side to side and some of the stretches will involve some twisting and turning. So, it doesn't have to be complex. Mm. It can just be you freestyling it. You can just stand there and start moving with your breathing. Start moving your arms around. You waving them from side to side. It doesn't really have to be anything particular. What it's about is about just, as Angie said before, getting the function of the body moving. And this also happens to help with the movement of hormones, with the movement of energy through the body,
toxins.
With the movement of toxins and water and things like that through the body. So here's some four simple things that you can do. Get out into the AM sunlight. Now, I want to add something on this. A lot of people, sunrise is a dirty word to some people that don't like getting up in the morning. It doesn't have to be sunrise. It can be just AM sunlight, anything before 12, right? Grounding, just taking your shoes off and getting your feet on the ground, especially into some water if you can. Breathing. Okay, we're gonna add a 12-minute breathing routine to the link in this podcast, and movement. You know, movement, even if the movement's a walk, even if you're walking while you're doing this, it's perfectly fine. So they're the four things that you can do to add into a morning routine.
But I wouldn't say don't do the breathing while you're walking if you've never done the breathing before, because the breathing will bring up some sensations. You're best to be in like a meditative state to relax into the sensations and just hand over the feelings to the breath and let the breath do what it needs to
do. I don't. I say do it walking. We've had people that have done the guided one walking, but as Angie mentioned, we're going to give you a guided one. Best to sit down with it. But if you're just going to breathe and walk, just breathe in time with your footsteps.
Yep. And you know what? Try both. Have a play, see what works for you, and try one of those four things, if not all four of those things, because I reckon in about 15 minutes to 30 minutes, you've released tension, you've powered up your body, you've connected with earth, and you've connected with yourself. And how would you be feeling from there to create a day? What kind of work day could you have, and what could you accomplish starting your day like that?
It's not in the words, it's in the practice.